In Android 4.4 KitKat, or API level 19, Android started getting really serious about coordinated motion. The new Scenes and Transitions API made it much easier to define how UI elements should move together. Let's take a look. The Scenes and Transitions API introduced a new paradigm for animating objects in your UI. James gave you a glimpse into this API, but it actually lets you do a whole lot more. The API allows you to define different states for your UI called scenes. There's actually two scenes in this example here. And also let you define ways to transition between those scenes, coordinating several UI elements at once. So when UI elements appear, disappear, move, or otherwise change, you could easily define the animations to use. In this example, you can see some of those elements moving, some elements appearing, and some disappearing. Pressing the Info or Close button switches between those two scenes. The way this works is you have two layouts which describe the two scenes. Here's what they look like. They're pretty simple, just some linear layouts, relative layouts, image views, text views, and buttons. Now the magic happens here in the on-click handlers. When you press the Info button, we use this new Transition Manager class to change from the current scene to the other one as defined by the second layout file. If we don't specify anything else, Android will automatically figure out some nice transitions for you, moving elements shared between the two scenes, fading new elements in, and fading old elements out. But let's say we wanted to customize the transition. We could do things like stagger the transition so that not everything happens all at once. For that, you could describe your custom transitions in XML and pass them into the Transition Manager like so. And here's an example of the custom transition XML. There are some similarities with the animation XML we talked about before, but the primitives you're working with, like change bounds and fade, are a bit different. As you can see, the animation capabilities in Android have been evolving, from basic animations in early Android to much richer capabilities in Ice Cream Sandwich, Jelly Bean, and KitKat. Let's go to Nick, who will tell us about the new animation capabilities in Android 5.0 Lollipop.